My dear brothers and sisters, peace be with you all. Today, Tuesday, in our Gospel, we have Mary Magdalene. And she goes to the tomb to visit the body of her good friend, special friend, Jesus Christ. And when she arrives there, she cannot find the body. And she's so sad. She cries. And a voice, an angel, comes to her and asks, "Why do you cry?" We know why she was crying. She lost her best friend. She lost the one who gave her an opportunity to restart her life. The one who stood by her when everybody was condemning her, when people were ready to stone her. That stranger stood there, looked that woman in her eyes, and he saw something special in her heart, something that nobody else was able to see. And that's the vision of God when he looks in our hearts. He can see the good things that nobody else can. And you know, that woman on that day was totally transformed. She embraced that opportunity and she never looked back. She walked with Jesus and stayed with him for the rest of her life. And yes, she was sad that day. But then the voice comes again, and the question the same. Why do you cry? And now Mary Magdalene recognizes the voice. It is you, Master Rabboni. She is full of joy again. What a great joy. She recognized the voice and the presence of Jesus right there beside of her on that day. And you know, how many times in our lives, when we are going through bad experiences, negative things, our fears, despair, isolation, when we are sick, when we lose someone who is very special for us, it is difficult to see God and recognize his voice in those moments. But again, God is right there telling us and asking us, why do you cry? Even when we cannot hear, God is there. And so many times, because God keeps repeating that same question, one day we'll be able to recognize. And we are going to see that, yes, God was right there with us every minute, every step. He never abandoned us. And then, like Mary Magdalene, we are also going to say, Master Rabboni, it is you. You were there with me all the time. And Mary Magdalene, after she recognized, she ran to Galilee to proclaim what she had seen, what she had experienced. She became a missionary. And that's the call for each one of us. When we experience God in our lives, and when we are able to recognize his voice, we go and we proclaim. We become missionaries. Because the same God that we experienced, we want other people experience and be transformed in the same way that we were. And I think that's the voice our world needs to hear right now. God knows that the world is suffering. The world is in pain. The world is crying, and we need to hear the voice of God asking us, why do you cry? Better days will come. Just trust. Do never lose your trust, your hope, and be patient. May Almighty God bless you and protect you today and always. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Have a good day. God bless you. Amen.